cover it, and we'll report back tomorrow. Now, the insiders got more on a pop
team. Right now on Access Hollywood.
People out there want Whitney Houston.
That is such a blessing.
Whitney's triumphant return. The star-studded turnout.
Hey, Jennifer.
Feel great.
This is the only place that matters at this point. Her dressing room.
Off the stage and only to us. But which fellow superstar couldn't believe her ears?
After you finished, she was at the podium and she was like, shh.
Bless her heart.
I cried myself to sleep.
Whitney Houston returns.
There's no denying Whitney wowed 'em. Hi, everybody. Welcome to Access Hollywood. I'm Sean Robinson. Nancy O'Dell was on The View today.
Hi, folks. I'm Billy Bush. And, Shawnee, you do not lie. It was quite a night. Last night, Whitney returned to Las Vegas, and seconds after her emotional performance, I was exclusively backstage with Whitney for her reaction.
Feeling right now is an emotional night.
Yeah, I feel good.
I've been leaving dreams again.
People out there want Whitney Houston. She's crossed into that national treasure.
That is such a blessing.
Area.
Yeah.
Did you feel that?
I thought that.
The man who launched her career, Clive Davis, by her side. Whitney was savoring her moment.
She is the best singer in the world. And so she showed tonight, you know, such heart, such power, such voice.
Performance and entertainment quality. I mean, just the pause. I will always love you. Let that crowd breathe because they know that moment's coming. Right? I mean, you were working it.
Yeah. No, okay. They made me feel so welcomed and so, you know, just loved.
Celine Dion said the nicest things about you. What, after you finished, she was at the podium and she was like, shh,
I
stop,
love
everyone
her.
Quiet, we're going to listen.
Her heart.
And the whole press room turned and watched
you.
And absorbed the moment.
Celine, on her knees, watched in awe, along with Courtney Love, who was moved to tears.
And we've been missing her tremendously. And to see her coming back, looking more beautiful, the way that we used to see her.
Love you.
Bobby, will Whitney return the favor?
What are the chances that you and Bobby do Oops, I Did It Again?
You'll love her answer. You just have to wait 2 minutes.
The bang, gracing the stage in Las Vegas at the World Music Awards, and moments after that knockout performance, we went backstage with Whitney and the man who launched her career, record mogul Clive Davis. Now we go back in time with the great Whitney Houston.
What is your favorite Whitney Houston song?
Probably The Greatest Love of All. That's where I started. That's where we met. It's from the heart. It says everything I feel about me, children, people, you know, about reaching that ultimate greatest love.
When I heard what she did to that song that I was so familiar with, you just know, you know. And I really went on, as soon as we signed, I went on a nationally television show.
Merv Griffin.
Just last week, Whitney once again mesmerized the crowd, returning to the stage for the World Music Awards.
If you could think of the ultimate duet to do with somebody right now, who would you choose?
You know, I love Tony Bennett. I would love to do something with Tony Bennett.
As for Whitney's 12-year-old daughter, she's a little more current.
What does Bobby Christina listen to? Who's she interested in? Who's
God.
Her the she, thing?
She loves Ashley Simpson. JoJo, get up right now.
JoJo's 13.
She loves JoJo.
Bobby Christina, take note. Today's stars get inspiration from your mom and dad.
Britney Spears is doing My Prerogative.
I heard.
She's remixed right now. She's doing the video doing My Prerogative.
Oh, that's my prerogative.
What are the chances that you and Bobby do Oops, I Did It Again?
No chance.
not likely.
Great idea, though, Billy. All right, tomorrow, the great Diana Ross tells us all about Whitney Houston.
And Whitney Houston gave Jessica's little sister a gift when she told us her daughter, Bobby Christina, loves that Ashley.
She loves Ashley Simpson.
Ashley was, she was so excited just to even hear Whitney Houston say her name.
Bobby Christina, take note. Ashley not only sings, but takes a stand rocking the vote on AOL.
Make your voice heard.
Britney's doing Bobby. How about Whitney doing Britney?
What are the chances that you do Oops, I Did It Again?
Dreams. Whitney's definitely back, and she's revealing her dream duet.
You know, I love to catch up.
Whitney's triumphant return. Britney's I Do's. Hi, everybody. Welcome to Access Hollywood. I'm Sean Robinson.
Hi, everybody. I'm Tony Potts.
Britney and Whitney, two music superstars, dominate the headlines.
Yes, they do, Sean. And we kick things off with Britney. Yep, she did it again, apparently.
Welcome back. We'll be seeing a lot more of Whitney Houston when Bobby Brown chronicles his famous family for his upcoming Bravo reality series. But what's up with her music career? Whitney and record mogul Clive Davis gave me the lowdown on her future.
I'm crazy about Whitney. She's just one of us. We just got to take care of each other.
I've been leaving dreams again.
Whitney Houston is now taking care of herself and taking care of business, belting out an astounding performance at the World Music Awards.
I was so proud because, you know, I had worked with her earlier this summer, and we had the best time, and I just kept on believing. And now she's on her own, and she's great, and I love her, and I hope we're going to work together soon.
Well, Whitney will probably be working a lot in upcoming months with record mogul Clive Davis back in her corner.
Clive Davis made Arista Records, and when he left a few years back, what did that do to you?
It hurt. I was in between, you know, and being loyal to Clive, but being loyal to Arista, you know, at the same time. I wasn't expecting it, and it kind of threw me back a little bit.
And with good reason. Whitney was just 19 when Clive Davis discovered her, knowing right away that she would be a star. With 6 Grammys, 7 consecutive number one records, and 11 number one singles, how did they top that? What's the plan?
The plan is to do just what we've always done. You make the best records with the best voice in the world. That's what you do. We don't even have to say it to each other. We know we're doing that album together.
We know what naturally comes to us, really.
Is there anything you really want to do? Is there anything you want to do differently?
No. I've done it. I just want to make music people can enjoy. And, you know, love by, live by, cry by, laugh by. You know, I've done it. There's nothing else I'm really expecting to do but just make great music.
Favorite Whitney song?
Oh, I have to say, My Love Is Your Love.
Nice. Well, that's it for us. Hold on, everybody.